So now let's cover adenosine. Adenosine is effective in terminating narrow complex SVT due to reentry involving AV or sinus node. It's used for unstable narrow complex reentry tachycardia, and it should be given while preparing to cardiovert. It's important to note that adenosine does not convert atrial fibrillation, atrial flutter, or ventricular tachycardia, known as V-tach. Adenosine is indicated for narrow complex supraventricular tachycardia, or SVT, unstable narrow complex reentry tachycardia, regular and monomorphic wide complex tachycardia, or as a diagnostic maneuver for stable narrow complex SVT. Adenosine is contraindicated in poison drug-induced tachycardia or second or third degree heart blocks. Now, it is safe during pregnancy. It's less effective in patients taking theophylline or caffeine, and if administered for irregular polymorphic wide complex tachycardia or V-tach, it could cause deterioration including hypotension. Its side effects include transient periods of flushing, chest pain or tightness, brief periods of asystole or bradycardia, and ventricular ectopy. Reduce the initial dose to 3 mg in patients receiving dipyridamole or carbamazepine, in heart transplant patients, or if given by central venous access. Remember that transient periods of sinus bradycardia and ventricular ectopy are common after termination of SVT. This medication should be delivered IV rapid push. First, place the patient in a moderate reverse Trendelenburg position before administration of the drug. The initial bolus of 6 mg is given rapidly over 1 to 3 seconds, followed by a normal saline bolus of 20 mL. It's recommended that the extremity in which the drug was administered be elevated. A second dose of 12 mg can be given in 1 to 2 minutes if needed. Now, while we're doing this, make sure to record a rhythm strip during administration. Draw up the adenosine dose and saline flush in 2 separate syringes. Attach both syringes to the IV injection port closest to the patient. Clamp the IV tubing above the injection port. Then push IV adenosine as quickly as possible. While maintaining pressure on the adenosine plunger, push the normal saline flush as rapidly as possible after the adenosine. Unclamp the IV tubing and monitor the outcome.